Hey everyone, welcome back. I know it's been a long ass time since I fucking recorded anything, but I'm finally done with school. Basically, I have some bullshit I need to deal with, but that's a future me problem. And I finally have a graphics card worth a damn, so I can actually start recording again. To be fair, I am very fucking rusty at this. I have not recorded in a long time. I've done crap on metal, but that was just me screwing around and getting a few good clips here and there. Also, I am absolutely garbage at this game. Do not expect anything good from me, and honestly, most of the time, I'm just typically a wreck. Every now and again, I will run in and, like, actually try to get into a fight or something. But that's typically only if I'm actually, trying to do some quests or something. And that's because I don't really have a choice at that point. Because this game will just tell me to go fuck myself and I'm gonna try to do a quest. Also, my inventory is currently a fucking shit show because I literally haven't done anything with it. Like, I've done 2 scav runs, but that's about it. And those were both today, and like, I just ran in, did a few stashes, and then got the fuck out. Also, I have no clue how the computer's gonna do with loading and recording because I still only have a regular hard drive in this, and I still take a little long to load in, just typically. So we're gonna see how this goes. And I did a few audio tests before this with the in-game music going, so I'm hoping that I can be heard right now over all the music. I'm gonna try my best to commentate, but that was never really a strong suit of mine. Like, I can talk to myself all fucking day long. I'm good at that. Just commentating what's going on and, like, trying to actively keep an audience. Like, that's something I'm very good at. I'm probably going to be doing recordings with one of my friends named Deary. If he ever decides that he's bored of his VR headset, or he wants to play something that I actually think is worth recording. We've been doing a good bit of, like, Ready or Not, and, what's the other game we've been playing? It's typically just been Ready or Not, some Siege, but not too much. Whenever I like to play Siege, he usually gets pissed off, which I don't blame him, that game is annoying as hell. Warthunder, that's what it is. Ready or Not, Warthunder. We were playing PUBG for a long time, but I guess we got bored or annoyed with that. He's every time I say anything about PUBG now, he's not really into it. Which kind of sucks, because I've not played that game since I got my graphics card. Like, literally only a few days ago. I got my graphics card, like, late Sunday. And I'm recording this late Tuesday night. Also, this first video I'm probably not gonna cut out because it's just like my introduction bullshit, like just me talking, whatever. So it's gonna be this boring ass loading screen. I'm gonna do this run for sure. I might do a PMC run. I know I need to get 133 shotguns because I literally, like I said, I've only done 2 scav runs. I haven't done anything else so far. Going on to my 3rd scav run. So I still have a lot of shit I need to do, especially since the game just wiped, I think, like, a week and a half ago or something. I don't know when it wipes. I haven't really been on this game too much because no one I know likes to play this game anymore, which is sad because this is a great game. Just let it be absolutely sweaty. But, I mean, that's just one of the charms of this game. It's sweaty, yes, but you don't always have to indulge in the sweaty behavior. Sure, you're going to get fucked up 95% of the time, but it's just the way it is. And luckily for me, I don't have to worry about monetization because my channel's small, so I can just curse whenever the hell I want to. I haven't really been paying attention to the YouTube guidelines much. I know recently there's been some backlash with them not allowing cursing within the first 15 seconds or whatever, and then you'll get unmonetized. But that's not something I have to worry about right now. I don't know how long it will be until I have to worry about that, because I think I need 1,000 subscribers, and I'm at, I think, like 21, 22 right now. So that's a very future problem. I'm glad they're finally coming out of my retirement break, whatever the fuck, from YouTube. YouTube's always been something I've enjoyed. Can I get a cue, please? It's been 5 minutes of just me sitting here and talking, waiting for a game. Oh god. Well, 7 minutes according to the recording, but 5 minutes in queue. I feel bad for this. Like I said, I'm not gonna... I am probably gonna start trying to actually get into editing. I did a lot of that with metal clips and shit, so... I'm more in tune with that now, but I'm still not really an editor. I don't know. Not really creative. Like, I've always had, like, a creative block or whatever. Never really been in tune with the creative side. I'm a fucking weirdo. Don't get me wrong, I'm a weirdo. It's probably entertaining enough for some people, but... I know I eventually want to get a legitimate intro and intro, whatever the fuck. Hopefully I actually get some people to record with, so it's not always just me trying to make commentary, because that's fucking boring and it sucks. I don't even remember the last time I recorded. I don't even remember what was going on back then. When was my last legitimate video? That is a very good question. Jesus fucking Christ, okay. Let's see. Okay, so my last legitimate video was Need for Speed Payback. Oh, God, yeah, that's been a while. Wow, okay. So in between that video and my Dying Light video, the one I recorded right before that, literally, also I need to update my channel because I haven't looked at that in a while, but I dated some people since then. I was in a 9-month-long relationship with someone, which did not end well. Then nothing went well after that. Like, it's, that 9-month relationship ended, like, August of 2021. And then after that, I was just constantly trying to date people, whatever, like, rebound relationships, whatever. then I, one of my friends had started dating someone, but some shit happened there, and then I ended up dating the person that he was dating, and some other shit happened, she broke up with me, whatever. It's been a constant shit show for the last, like, 2 years. Nothing has really gone in my favor or anything like that. Like, it's... And back to what I said about school or whatever. Literally, I technically passed school. Like, I technically graduated. But I didn't graduate because I needed a 3.0 GPA. And when they told me I needed a 3.0 GPA, I only had a 1.0. with like 2 months of school left, and by the end of the school year I had brought it up to 2.74, because I realized I actually had to start doing something in school, because before that I couldn't have given less of a shit about school. And then I didn't pass that, so I was like, alright, cool, whatever. And, after that, I've only really been working. Like, I had a surgery, November of 2021, and I was homeridden for, like, 4.5 months, because I could not walk. And I finally got back into work, and I've just been slowly trying to reacclimate with working and, like, trying to deal with the pain of working after the surgery. And this was by far my most painful fucking surgery ever. I've never had a surgery hurt this bad, but this is also the first surgery I've ever had while working. And I need to be doing something. Like, if I'm stuck inside, not able to do anything or whatever for months at a time, it's going to affect me. And you're going to be able to tell that there's something wrong with me, because during that entire time, like, I was just laying in bed most of the time crying, either because of pain or because I felt useless, and I hate feeling useless. Like, I've spent my entire life, like, trying to, have the shit I do mean something, because I was always told, oh, you can't do this, you can't do that. Or, you won't be good at this, you won't be good at that, bullshit like that. And my entire life I just strive to tell those people, basically, go fuck yourself. I can do this just as well as you can. Maybe not as efficiently, but I will find my own ways to make it more efficient and still be a really good fucking worker. Like, I know I'm probably going to get hate for this, because everyone fucking hates the people that works in this profession. But I work at McDonald's. I've worked there for a year and a half. And sure, it's not the most glamorous job. Sure, it's not the fucking best paying job out there. But I was blessed with the fact that my boss is, like, a fucking amazing person. Like, she, when I told her about the surgery, she had no problems with it. She was just like, alright, cool, whatever. And, like, they literally even threw me a party before I left, just to be like, hey, we hope everything goes well, good luck, we'll see you when you come back. And they literally told me, when I am ready to start working again, if I want to, I can just go right back to working there. They never fired me, they never took me off the schedule or anything. I was always an employee there. For the 4 months, I was laid up, not able to do anything. And, like, the fact that I was... Now, to be fair, it could have just been them being nice, but it made me feel like I actually meant something to the business. And I came back, everyone who knew me when I was working there, like, they were all happy I was back, like, and, I don't know, it's been pretty fucking awesome, honestly, like, I could not have asked for better coworkers or managers or boss. Now, I have had problems with coworkers before, but my bosses, at least, they've, like, my boss, managers, whatever, they've always been pretty fucking amazing. Like, they're understanding with me. They know for a fact, like, I cannot be on my feet all the time. And, like, just working there, I am constantly in need of being on painkillers. Literally not a single day I go by working where I do not need painkillers. And, like, recently I've been trying not to take painkillers because I do not want to be stuck on painkillers for the rest of my life. It's fucking terrible. I do not want to be reliant on that. But, like, despite that, like, I'm trying my best every day to, like, stay relevant or whatever in the workplace, make sure that I'm earning my points and shit like that, like, I know this is a lot of rambling, I'm realistically just trying to make conversation because I don't know what the fuck to say, but so much bad shit has happened the last while. Like, I've needed something good to happen. Just... And, like, coming back to this, like, I'm hoping there will be... Sorry. What the fuck? Yo, who's backpack stacking? Who the fuck is this guy? Who killed me? A scav. Bro, that's the last fucking analyzer I need. Don't scare me like that, scav. That was terrifying. I completely forgot what I was talking about, too. Probably a good thing for you guys, because, God, that was a long-ass rant. Well, I don't know, like, I'm glad to be back on fucking YouTube and shit, like, YouTube, like, doing YouTube, this is something I've always wanted to do, like, even if I'm not making money or whatever.
Ну чё, неплохой день, да? Чётко всё.
I really hope you're an actual scavenger up player, because a fucking actual player might whoop my ass. I don't know, I wasn't even talking about game commentary or anything either, like, I've just been on a full-on fucking rant just talking about shit. And I mean, to be fair, there's probably nothing wrong with that, it's just, I don't know. I don't really talk to people that much anymore. I have a couple of friends I talk to here and there, but if there's anything I'm good at, it's pissing people off and making them not want to talk to me. That's for damn sure. I don't even know why I'm saluting. Like, I need that. I need this. No, it doesn't say I need this yet. It's because I need to get this fucking quest done. But, I don't know, man. I'm also, I'm pretty sure I'm like starting to show symptoms of ADHD or some bullshit. Like, I don't think I legitimately have ADHD, but my train of thought, like, it's just been all over the place, and concentrating has, that's been a fucking situation. Concentrating, fucking, like, only doing one thing at a time. Like, when I started my relationship a couple of years ago, the 9 month long relationship, I was able to just sit there and talk to her the entire fucking time. But towards the end of the relationship, I was completely incapable of just sitting there and talking to her. I needed to be on a video game, I needed to be doing anything, like cleaning my room, fucking anything. I could not just sit down and talk. And that was one of many things that inevitably drove her away, because people I tend to be are usually pretty clingy, whatever. And I mean, it's on me for sure, but like, a lot of the people I date, they typically need attention 24 hours a day. Otherwise, it's gonna start being pissed off at you. And I understand it. Like, I understand, like, wanting attention from your significant other and whatever. But realistically, you can't expect them to just sit, like, she even told me to get a job. Like, she's the reason why I fucking got a job. So, like, that part doesn't exactly completely make sense to me, but, like, whenever I was home or whatever, she always wanted to be on call, always wanted me talking to her. But instead, I was always talking to her and friends, and I would always be playing a video game. And it's, like, I feel bad for it, but honestly, there's nothing I could do. Like, mentally, I cannot just sit around and only do one thing. Like, with my friends, I've always, like, I've never been able to just sit down and just talk to them. I always had to have a game up in order to actually just be able to talk to them. Because I cannot just focus on a conversation. I need to focus on a conversation and a game. Or I need to focus on a conversation and doing homework, some shit like that. Despite being someone who never gave a shit about school, I had to at least be doing some fucking homework while talking to people in order to, I guess, stay interested. Like, it's not that I wasn't interested in the conversations, it's just I could not just be the person they wanted me to be, just sitting there talking to them all day. Like, I had to actually fucking do something. And then, as you guys can tell, I'm also really good at, like, roundabouting the conversation. Like, I can be talking about one thing, finish that subject, and then 20 seconds later, here I am talking about that exact same thing over again. It's just like, what the fuck? How did you get back to this? And I never know. It's just something I do. A syringe, I need that. But also, fuck you, there's a syringe, I need that. God damn it. Wait, can I check this? Quality pose, I would love that. I'm gonna get rid of a CMS for that. Yeah, I don't know. And I guess I just like talking about personal shit a lot, like If something's going on with me, I love to talk about it. Like, I don't like hiding things from people, which has always gotten me in trouble in the past with some people. Like, someone will be like, hey, don't say this to someone or something. And I'll just be like, well, if it's nothing important, then why not say it to them? Like, a lot of it, like, it's not even insults or whatever. It's just like, well, I mean, sometimes it was insults. But, like, to me, if you don't want someone to know about something, don't talk about it at all. And because there's a, like, if you talk about something, there's a chance that someone else is going to figure out about it, whether or not you wanted them to. And whether that be from someone you did talk about it with, talking to a friend that they thought had no connection with the person you were talking about, or some other bullshit. They're always going to figure it out sooner or later. And I'm just like, I don't like lying to people. I don't like keeping things from people. Like, I don't like the half-truths thing. I don't like the fucking keeping things from people. I'm just like, be honest with each other. I don't care. Like, especially with me, I'm like, I don't care if it's the painful truth. I'd much rather a painful truth than a sweet fucking lie. Like, I'd rather be told, I hate you, when someone does hate you, rather than them saying, I love you, or you're a great person, some bullshit like that. No, I want to hear, what the fuck do you think is wrong with me? Why that's a problem? And if there's anything I can do about it, please tell me. Because I'm not good at fixing my own problems unless I actually get them pointed out. Like, I need someone to be like, hey, I don't like this about you. And if I agree, like, okay, yeah, that's some shitty thing I do, whatever, some crap like that, then I will try my damnedest to go out of my way and solve that issue. But if it's something, like, I know I can't do anything about or whatever, I'm just gonna be like, sorry you feel that way. If you don't like it, then honestly, you can just leave. I don't have time for someone that doesn't want to deal with me. If you don't want to deal with me, I don't want to deal with you. And I honestly adopted that mindset because of people I dated. They would love to put up with me as long as whatever was wrong with me wasn't too much. I was extremely depressed or whatever from past relationships, the fucking surgery, the surgery especially. Like, I've been going in and out of depressive episodes constantly, and there was some people who was just like, all right, yeah, I can deal with this every now and again. And when it started becoming like every other day or every week or literally the entire week, then like a couple days off, and then we're right back at it. I ended up driving away a lot of people, and I feel bad for putting people through my shit. It's never like I lied to them about it. I was just like, listen, if you're going to date me, this is something you have to know about me. Because I'm fucked in the head. I have issues. I'm not gonna lie. I have issues. And I can try and work on them, but the more I acknowledge them, the more I realize how bad it is, and like half the time there's literally no fixing it, because whenever I realize what is wrong, all I do is make it worse, because I start pointing it out with myself, I start hating myself because of whatever's wrong, and in turn that, like, anyone who's ever dated anyone, you probably know that if you start hating yourself while dating them, It is like the biggest red flag, the thing they're going to fucking yell at you the most for. Especially with how people are nowadays, it's like I prefer the old school mentality of like, if it's broken, instead of leaving, how about we stay, figure out what's wrong, and try and fix it. But nowadays, most people, they'd much sooner leave than fucking give you the chance to fix yourself. I understand it, like, if you're not showing initiative, like, if you're not actually trying, then yeah, fucking break up with the person, whatever. But in the case of me, for example, like, I have had issues like that. Like, they'll give me multiple chances, whatever, and, like, I'll never actually do anything, but I ask for their help with it. Because dealing with those emotions alone is probably the hardest fucking thing you can ever do. It is a roller coaster, it's painful, it's all you're gonna do is end up hurting yourself, hurting the other person. And like I had with my 9 month relationship, we literally created a plan to help me with my shit and make sure I can get better so that I can stop pissing them off. And they broke up with me 2 days later because I was, quote, too much to deal with and was not worth their fucking time. Which, after a 9 month long relationship, that stings. Like, that fucking hurts. That is someone you thought you could trust, whatever. And then all of a sudden there's like, hey, by the way, fuck you. I can't deal with you anymore. Don't mind that voice, right? And I hope you go kill yourself. And then that also introduced me into the world of how people are, well, how some women are, not all people. I'm not gonna fucking discredit every fucking person just because of some bullshit in my past. But some women, they will literally go out of their way to make sure your life is ruined for as long as they possibly fucking can. Like, after I broke up, well, sorry, after she broke up with me, I found out literally only a couple months ago that she started telling lies, saying like I was gonna rape her or whatever, and I was just like, if you actually showed people the conversations we had, you would, like, everyone would know that you're full of shit. Because I was an asshole. I will not lie about that. I was an absolute fucking asshole. Whether or not I was an asshole on their terms or just an asshole in my own mind, which made me an asshole to them. Like, for example, fucking hating on myself, which that was one of the biggest fucking problems they had with me. Like, just hating on myself, like, I consider that as me being an asshole. Because doing that when you're in a relationship, it fucking hurts the other person and makes them think they're worthless or some bullshit or whatever. I don't know. This has become less of a gaming experience and more of like, hey, welcome to Thomas's Shrink Hour. How may I help you? But to be fair, I'm just trying to compensate because I don't know what the fuck I'm doing here. And do I even have enough time left in this recording? I set my recordings to automatically split like every 45 minutes or whatever so that I don't have fucking 3 hour long videos like I used to. And to be fair, this is probably the shittiest video I've ever produced because it's literally just been me ranting about my past like 2 fucking years. Like, when I went on break from YouTube, I had only ever dated one person, but that person was never a significant part of my life because over the 3 years I was technically dating them, I had like maybe 4 hours of talking to them in total, and like maybe 200 messages. And like, I was just like, alright, cool, whatever, this is how relationships are, or some bullshit like that. Which then I got into that one relationship. And I was like, oh, this is what an actual relationship is. Holy shit, this is like the greatest thing ever. Until it wasn't. I don't know. God, I feel like a lot of these videos are probably just gonna end up me being like diving into my past and then also because of that going into like a depressive fucking episode. Just something I'm good at, that's for damn sure. If there's anything I'm good at, it's being depressed. I don't know. Also, I'm sorry that most of this fucking video has just been menus. There's not much I could have done about that. I started the intro, started talking a whole lot, and then because of me talking a whole lot, it was like fucking 9 minutes of loading, which could have been avoided. But I know I'm not gonna edit that out because I was talking a lot, whatever. To be fair, not all of it is important. It's shit I should not be talking about on YouTube, whatever. But at the same time, I'm a small YouTuber. I'll get, like, if I'm lucky, a few views. And since it's not even riveting gameplay, it's not gonna be the most. Don't know. But my mind keeps trailing off into places that I should not be fucking trailing off to while recording. Which is made obvious by the last, like, 40 minutes of recording footage. That's just been me ranting. Don't know. I really need to get better at this fucking whole YouTube thing. It's been a long time since I did it. The last time I did it, I was on par for the course. I don't know. I don't know. If anyone does watch this, other than me fucking talking about shit I should not have been talking about this entire time, if there's anything wrong with this video, besides that, obviously, go ahead and tell me what was wrong in the comments. If there's anything you want to talk about, go ahead and talk about it in the comments. As long as you're following YouTube term of service, I'm not gonna give a crap. You can talk about whatever you want in the comments. I won't delete your comments. YouTube will if they don't like what the fuck you post, but go ahead and feel free to talk, like, dislike the video. If you do dislike the video, tell me what's wrong with the content, tell me if there's anything I need to fix. If you just dislike it because it was boring and I was talking too much about my past, go ahead and tell me that's why you disliked it, or go ahead and not tell me why you dislike the video. It doesn't really matter, it's up to you. I would greatly appreciate the feedback. If you don't want to give me that feedback, that's fine. And with all that said, I think that's everything for right now, so Have a good night, good day, whatever time it is for you, and I'll see you next time.